Hello guys, so in this video we will see this particular problem, check if word can be placed in crossword. So what this problem basically says, let's see. You are given a matrix m cross n board representing the current state of the crossword puzzle. The crossword contains lower case English letters. Okay, so basically what it is saying is you are given a crossword here and this contains a lowercase English letters only. It can contain hash. As you can see, this empty space character, space character to represent empty shell, and hash character to represent the block cell. So basically, this is what it says. If you see here, hash, hash, and then space, space, hash, hash. So basically, it is representing this. Hash means blocked. So you can see these are blocked. Basically, this is blocked. This is blocked. This is blocked. This is not there. Okay, this particular column is not there, and this is blocked. So basically, you are left with only these four. So if you see, you are left with only these four. Let me change the color. Yeah, these four. Okay, and here. So basically, now we have to see whether we can put this word ABC here or not. So basically, we can put here ABC in this row. And for putting the word also, there are some constraints that when you put a word in a crossword, no space should be at the starting or the end, whether you put it horizontally or you put it vertically. Okay, so if you have put your word horizontally, no space should be here or at the starting or the end. If you put your word vertically, no space should be there at the top or at the bottom. So this is basically what this problem says is, so basically you are given a crossword and you have to search, like see whether this particular word that is given can be put in this crossword according to these four constraints available. Okay, so let's see how to proceed with this particular problem. So see, I have used regex here, and how to derive this regex expression from these strings, let's see that. So here, with respect to this particular input, this is our grid. So we can travel for a word in either horizontal direction or vertical direction. And in horizontal direction also, we can move from left to right or from left right to left. Here we can move from top to bottom or from bottom to top. So we have to see how many different regex strings we can extract from this input. So let's see, this string is blocked, so let me move from horizontally. When moving in this row horizontally, this is blocked, so we cannot take this. This is okay, so our string will be like this, and a dot which represents any character can be inserted. Moving from the second, we have two dots because this is blocked. Here moving the third, we have C and then dot. So any pattern matching with this. Now see, ABC is here. We can put it like this, A, B, C. No trailing spaces at the end or at the starting. Okay, no. So this is a valid sequence. Had it been like this, like you have put A, B, C and then there are trailing spaces, that would have been wrong. So basically here it is right, so it will return true. Now we have moved horizontally here. Now we can also move vertically here as well, right? So while moving vertically, what are the different types of patterns that we can generate is, see here we can generate a single dot only. Here we can represent dot dot C. Okay, and then here we can represent only a single dot. So basically if you can see, when we run our pattern regex, we can clearly see this ABC will match with this one and this will return true. Okay. So similarly, we are going to see with other problems. Let's see here. So here, if we'll try to form this regex expression using this, so what we can do is we can get dot A dot C dot A again, and then here if we do it horizontally, that this was done when horizontally. When doing here vertically, what we can do is we can get triple dot and then A C A. Okay, now you must be saying like what about traversing in the opposite direction? So basically, instead of traversing in the grid in the opposite direction and generating multiple patterns to match, why we can simply do it, we can take the word, reverse it itself, we can put it CA as AC and then match with the pattern. This would be a much better solution. Okay, why? Because if we have generated these many patterns, suppose here, by traversing only in horizontal and in vertical direction. If we traverse in like right to left and from bottom to right, like more number of patterns will be generated, and that will take time, as well as when this pattern matching is done, that will also take time because we have to loop over each pattern. So basically what we can do, when we have one pattern, we can simply take this string, match it, or reverse the string and match it. That would be a much better solution. Okay. So that's it. This is the main question. The pattern matching and everything is taken care of by the library itself. So let's see how we can do. So here what I have done, I have put a hash set. So basically, in the previous problem we have seen, right, we have duplicate dots here, here, here. So to remove those only, I have used hash set here. So as to see, well, we don't do duplicates. Then this M is length of the board. This is the number of columns, n is number of columns, m is number of rows. Here what we are doing, we are traversing, you see, from 0 till m, I is equal to 0 till m, and here j is equal to 0 to n, j is equal to 0 to n. So we are traversing horizontally one by one, and then whatever pattern that we are getting, if it is a space character, we are putting dot, else we are putting the character itself. Now what I am doing is, suppose we have got hash here, and here an empty string, and here an empty string. So basically what I am doing is, I am putting it like this, dot hash dot. Now since we cannot use hash, what I am doing is, I am splitting these two, just like here. Here while moving horizontally, what is the pattern that we can get, dot hash a, and then we will split this particular pattern by hash. Okay, now this will be dot and a altogether, because these two cannot be a single string, right, because of this blocked cell. So we'll get dot hash a and then split it based on hash. So we'll get two strings separately here. So now let's see. So that only we are doing. We are doing splitting here and then adding the list of strings that we are getting to this map, this hash set. And then similarly we are doing when we are traversing vertically. This is for horizontal and this is for vertical. Okay, now when we have done that, we have added all the string. What we are doing is, see, we have our word here. We are filtering out at first from this set itself. We are first filtering out what are all the strings that don't have the length of word, the same length as word. Those we are removing, and then we are picking up only those which have the same length, because then only that can match, right? Then what we are doing, we are taking the string that is the pattern, and then what we are doing, you can see, we are this SB is a string builder here, which is our word. We are matching it with the matcher one, and then we are reversing it, then again matching it. Okay, so if any of these two are true, then we'll return true, else false, and this we are going to do for each pattern. Okay, so this was the easy solution. It took a bit of time, but the solution was accepted. Okay, so let me submit this problem. Problem is submitted. It took time, but it is accepted. Okay, so this code, you can find the link in the description. You can go ahead and check this problem. Okay. Thank you.